Hey lovebugs, it's Roslynn back at you one more again. I hope everybody is doing blessed. I'm doing blessed and highly favored and definitely hope the same for you. And if this is your first time stopping by my channel, much love to you and welcome. And to my returning subs, my growing extended beautiful family, just thank you so much for the love and support that you're giving yourself, even though I know it can be hard at times to, you know, see better days or even think of better days. But you keep pushing, think about positivity, and more positivity will come your way. So with that being said, much love to all. Namaste, love and blessings, love and light, and many blessings are definitely coming your way. Also, if you've been watching my videos for a while and have not already, please like and subscribe. Even hit that notification bell so you know when I'm about to upload my next video. Also, if you feel like you're comfortable enough, please drop me a line or two. I love a chance to get to know you as much as you're getting to know me. Even if it's about the positive feedback of the content of my video, or you just help tell me about your impact, the gift, and how it impacted your life and heading you towards a positive direction. Also, if you feel like the video gave you good vibes or good information you would love to share with a fellow empath, or especially if somebody struggling to get towards positivity right now, go ahead and please share. And while you're at it, give me a thumbs up and also share on your social media favorites wherever you see fit. So thank you so much for stopping by my channel and giving me so much love and support as I do the same for you. And I hope you're able to resonate with the content of my video. Today, my meditation music I'm listening to today is 963 hertz life force energy frequency of God's miracle tones, and I will post that link in the description box below. And today my video is about twin flame 101, when it's hard to see the blessings coming your way, you know. Oh goodness, since this merge, it has been truly a blessing. Even though I miss my father terribly, he always keeps telling me, don't sit up here and say that because I'm always with you. And you know, if you're with your twin flame and merge, you know, there's we always want for union, but it's just we're already in oneness already as it is. You're your twin and your twin is you. But when you're going through so many things, it's kind of hard, especially if it's negative, it's kind of hard for you to see the blessings that are coming your way. You have to pay attention to the signs, knowing, you know, it's not going to come when you're ready for it to come. Divine timing is going to make sure that happens. God, universe, make sure that happens. But you have to be able to be a partnership in your own happiness, be able to push out love and positivity. Even when people don't show it to you, you have to show it to yourself. You know, you can't put your happiness in somebody else's hands. You really can't. I always used to go to my dad all the time because I wanted to feel loved. I wanted to feel happy. You know, even though I put so much love and emphasis on him because of knowing that I had him in my life this whole time. And it hurt to actually not be able to get into that physical union. But I also had to be able to show myself that love as well. You know, you can love somebody so much, but you have to be able to love yourself just the same way as you love other people. And going through these times, especially these trying times, you know, we're all getting activated for something that is coming towards our way. So it's really making you face dark times. It's really making you face things that has held you back and hindered you for so long. It is really making you face a lot of things that, you know, you fear. You know, we all fear the unknown. We all, you know, most of us fear change. You know, it's not something that, you know, you should be afraid of, especially to admit, you know, hey, I'm scared of change. Hey, I'm scared because I don't know what's going to come tomorrow. But you have to be able to, you know, see that. Push that positivity in your life, even though sometimes it's hard to see it, you know, with all the people that are around you that's affecting your happiness. You can't allow them to have that much power over you. And it's just like so many of my friends are going through that. I was just going through it. And it took a lot for me to have to know I deserve to be happy. I deserve to be happy. I deserve happiness. I deserve joy. You know, being sad and being mad is only going to just stunt your growth, you know, block your blessings. And then sometimes when you're going through that negative cycle, which can be hard, it's hard to see the beautiful things that are coming towards your way, especially if you're looking at the synchronicities, the signs, people saying certain things to you. The devil doesn't want to see nobody happy. You know, darkness does not want to allow to see anybody happy. Ego, you know, keep on preaching about ego, because ego can be a dangerous thing. It can tell you, oh, things are going to stay like this for a long time, or, you know, they're right. They said this and this and that about you. You have to be able to say, you know what? Bump that. I'm going to get my happiness. I'm going to head towards my blessings. I'm going to push out more blessings. When you're thinking about the positivity, knowing you're pushing out love and light, you have to train your mind. You know, if you have to say mantras every morning, you have to say affirmations, positive affirmations to yourself every day. I'm going to conquer my sadness. I'm going to overcome my negativity. I'm going to change my thought process. I'm going to become this person, or I am this person. You know, you have to be able to tell yourself that each and every day until the point you're believing that. But it's just like, if we give so much power into that negativity, just think about how much, if you put that much emphasis and power on your negativity, think how much if you did the same thing to something positive, how you would form positiveness towards your way as well. So it's just like, you have to be able to see the signs, see the synchronicities. You know, I used to always say all the time, especially when people are close to me, they used to always hear me say, I push out so much positivity, but I have so much negative that comes back. You know, I said, the universe is a lie. You know, they sit up here and tell me the more you, whatever you push out, the more whatever you will get back. And I will always pay attention to what the negative was coming towards me. But even if I pushed out positivity, I have to be able to believe it at the same time. I was pushing it out, but not believing it, putting that strength behind my words. And, you know, we can be at fault for that. I'm not going to lie. I did that. You know, that's why I always try to keep it real with y'all. Keep it honest with y'all. Because nobody's perfect. We're all going through a learning process. But it's just, you know, we can fall so many times. But the importance is when you get back up. When you're saying, okay, you know, I failed. I had the setback. I made this mistake. I had this fault. But I'm going to make myself better. I'm going to teach myself better. I'm going to, you know, preach myself better. You have to be able to do that. You know, happiness is not going to come towards you if you're not believing it. You can't sit up here and push out change when you're not trying to change. And, you know, there's so many times we go through these situations and we hinder on things that have hurt us. You know, I did that for a long time. I thought about so many times, oh, my stepmom and my adopted dad did this to me. They kept me from my family. You know, my family has passed on and I wasn't able to see this. I am not putting my power in those people that did those things to me, because you have to pray for people like that. Anybody who has hurt you, pray for them. You have to be able to, okay, sit your problems there. And say, okay, these things just happened to me, but I'm not going to allow them to keep happening to me. I had to pray for them people. I don't even give them that kind of power. They're not even in my life anymore. I'm not going to allow them to be in my life anymore. But just to know, better things are coming. I know there's a purpose behind every pain I have endured, every pain I've experienced. And it's just to know, when I'm able to make positive videos to let people know, hey, we go through the toughest things every single day. We might have been raped. We might have been beat down. We might have been, you know, cursed out and done so many different ways. But it's just, you cannot be a product of your situation. You cannot be a victim of the situations that you have been placed in. When you can be the billboard of saying, okay, I was in a negative situation, but I'm turning it into a positive outcome. That's when you know that things are blessed for you. And that's when you know, things are going to get better. Things will come your way, but you have to be able to believe in them. Don't just speak it, but you have to believe in the words that you're speaking. Because if you're pushing out positivity, but you have these negative thoughts, what do you think is going to come towards you? Negative situations. When you're putting so much emphasis on things that are not bringing you joy, you know, what people are telling you, people will sit up here and point faults at you when they don't want to see what's right about you. People will throw dirt on your name when they see things they wish they can have the power to do, but they're not doing that. Because I used to look at people and say, you know what? You're throwing so much bad things on my name. You know, we all can win at the same time, but why are you worried about what is on my journey? You can't compare your journey to somebody else's journey, because that's their journey. This is your journey. But you can achieve that, just like if God and universe is able to bless me with something, they can bless it with you too. But you have to be able to know that better days are coming. You have to be able to push out that positivity and believe the words that you are pushing out. You know, think of the things that are coming towards my way. You know, when there is a negative thought that comes up, turn that, convert it over to something positive. Like, okay, these people hurt me. All right, yes, they did hurt you, but I'm not going to allow them to hurt me anymore. I'm going to be that best person I can be. You can't make somebody else change, but you can be responsible of how you respond to negativity. You know, there's times, oh, a matter of fact, prime example, I told my friend I was going to do this, and it was so funny. I had somebody come on my 1044 video and tell me that my God is not God, it's Lucifer. I got my minions and I'm devil worshiping. I wanted to go boogity woody woody. You know, I'm going to send my little minions at you. And I thought the mess was so funny because you can't place emphasis on me by one video. Okay, one video or even two videos, because I know I'm pushing out something positive. You know, not everybody's going to like me. That's fine. I mean, the old Roslynn would have, you know, quit and said, I give up. I'm tired of people coming at me. Stuff like that I have to laugh at and keep going because, you know, there's people that try to provoke me. There's people that try to throw dirt on my name or even come on my channel and push out negativity, thinking that they were going to have this negative train going on. But like I tell people, I always review my comments before I push them out. I'm not going to allow somebody to try to take away my Fifth Amendment right for me to say something positive to help somebody throughout their day, send out love towards them, because I don't worship no devil. The devil is a lie. You know, I've had hellish things happen to me, but I'm not from that. So it's just like when things like that happen, people have a short mind. When they're talking about, I hate you and stuff like that, you don't even know me to hate me. That sounds like something you're trying to push towards yourself because of something that happened to you. I mean, that's a personal thing, but I'll go ahead and push out prayers. I'm like, I'm gonna pray for that person, because I thought it was funny, because it's funny and it's sad at the same time, because somebody would just actually put that much emphasis on, you know, if you don't like my video, best thing you can do is just unsubscribe me or just not even write a comment, because I'm not gonna allow you to, you know, mess up my day by your ignorance. So know that there are better days coming for you. Know that you control your happiness. You can push that out. Regardless of what people say about you is how you believe in yourself. What do you think in yourself is what's important. And I hope you are able to resonate with content in my video. Like and subscribe. Have a blessed day. I've been praying for everybody. I had to just take that day off for myself, y'all. It's just been tiring. But knowing better days are coming. So I'm sending a shout out to Ricky Von Brilfault. I hope I pronounced your name right. Reku. I'm sorry. Stacy Folly. Empaths. Caliber Inc. Crazy Living. Much love to you as well. And I will see you on my next video. Like and subscribe. Even hit that notification bell. Send out as much love and light and positivity as you possibly can. And know better days are coming. You are highly blessed, forever loved, and somebody's always praying out there for your better days. So send out as much love and positivity as you possibly can, and I will see you on my next video. Much love. Peace. Be wild.